타로루 제티레 타로레 거주자시 From holy heaven above, children of holy Celestia. From holy heaven above, we all shout for joy. We all dance with joy. We all shout Alleluia. Whoever belongs to God, no evil can confront him. Whoever belongs to God, no evil talolu shetireh talole kodju jasi. Children of Holy Celestia, from holy
welcome to Celestial World. Welcome to the presence of God. Welcome to the place of signs and wonders.
Welcome.
I am congratulating you.
At this time,
because we have all found the grace before the Lord to be at the right place and at the right time. God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Welcome to the presence of God. Welcome, welcome. Welcome to the presence of God. Let us quickly take this time out to begin to share. Let us take this time out as we begin to share this live broadcast. And I say, God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus as you do this in Jesus' name. Mommy Fashola, God bless you, man. God bless you. God bless you. Oh, Baba me, Ola Dipupo Fade Ibi, God bless you, sir. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Welcome to Celestial World. Welcome to the presence of God. Welcome to the place of the miraculous. And I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that our coming here today shall be full of God's blessings. In the mighty name of Jesus. Please let us begin to share this live broadcast as we are coming online. Let us share. Let us share. Invite as much as many people as you can, bring them before the presence of God. Please, let us share, let us share. Yes, let us invite as much people as we can, bring them before the presence of the Lord. And I say, God bless you as you do this in the mighty name of Jesus. Mama Ogunsemowo, God bless you. We are glad to have you here. Please let us, if you are a true follower of this program, I want you to please begin to share this live broadcast. Please begin to share. Invite as many people as you can. Invite your shepherd. Invite your head of prophets. Invite head of the usher. Invite the evangelist, invite your husband, invite your wife, invite every Celestians that you know. And like about how we do things in Celestial Church of Christ, please, I would like you to invite them, bring them before the presence of the Lord. Yes, invite them so that we can all learn. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. The live broadcast has been shared with my friends. Oh, Christopher Lade, God bless you, man, in the mighty name of Jesus. Welcome to Celestial World, the place of love, the place of possibilities. God bless you. Today is the continuation of the topic that we have been discussing, and it's going to be very powerful. I do not. Afterwards, we looked at authorities. The kinds of anointing, getting the anointing so important to me as a Christian. Then after that, we are going to look at the four ways to receive. Four ways by which we can receive the anointing. God bless you as you join us in the mighty name of Jesus. Shall we pray? Jehovah, Jesus Christ, Holy Michael, Gracious Father, we thank you. King of glory, we bless your name. We thank you because you are God. Accept our thanks in the mighty name of Jesus. We commit to this program in your hands. Lord, we pray that you should have your way in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we are inviting the Holy Spirit of God to teach us, to quicken us. Let your spirit descend powerfully in our midst today in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, speak to us. Lord, speak to us. Let there be a release of your word. Send your word to us today in the mighty name of Jesus. And as we receive your word, let every yoke be broken. Let lives be set free. Let blessings descend in the mighty name of Jesus. I cover everyone under the sound of my voice. I cover everyone in the atmosphere of this live broadcast to the blood of Jesus. And I say in the mighty name of Jesus, that what you have been asking from God, the Lord shall visit you today, and there shall be a shout of testimonies in your household. Thank you, gracious Father, because you have answered. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. I welcome us once again to this powerful program, Celestial World. And like I said earlier, if you are watching us right now live, I am congratulating you because you are at the right place and at the right time. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that there shall be a touch of the Spirit and the power of God in our lives today, in the mighty name of Jesus. We have been discussing the topic anointing and the anointment for a long time. We are using our church, Celestial Church of Christ, as a case study. And I told us, because this is the time that the pastor is traveling from countries to countries, giving people anointment for work and for service in the house of God. And what led to this topic is the fact that you cannot get the anointment without getting the anointing. And when you get the anointment without receiving the anointing, then the whole purpose, the entire purpose of giving you the anointment may be a waste. So in other words, we need to learn to wait patiently before the presence of the Lord to receive the anointing, before setting out to get the anointment, and before being recommended for promotion and a shift in spiritual ranks in the church. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that the Lord will lead us through today in the name of Jesus. So today we are discussing just two powerful topics. Number one, why do I need the anointing? Then number two, how to receive the anointing. We have talked extensively about the anointing. And I know a lot of people cannot wait to receive the anointing and then to begin to feel the power and the move of the power of God in their lives. But we need to understand why getting the anointing is so important. We need to understand why we actually need to receive the anointing of God in our lives. Then after getting that, after having an understanding about that, then we now begin to look at how to receive the anointing of the Lord in our lives. Now, why do I need the anointing? God bless you, Adetayo Adetola Ades. We are glad to have you here. That's my PA in Nigeria. God bless you, bro. Keep shining for God in the mighty name of Jesus. So, why do I need the anointing? I will start by letting us know that we all must first know that we are called into the ministry. That is the first thing I want us to know. In order for you to get a deep understanding about the topic of today, in order to understand why we are here, in order to get in full measure the package, the spiritual package of God's anointing that God bless you. Thank you, Sister Victoria Fajano. So in order for us to do that, I want us to understand the fact that we all must know this for sure, that we are called into the ministry. We are all called into the ministry. Many times in Celestial Church of Christ, when we mention the ministry, the first thing that comes to our mind is that, oh, he is referring to the shepherd. He is referring to the evangelist. No. I need you to first get this right this afternoon, that we are all called into ministry. And I will establish my point by reading Ephesians, the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verses 11 to 13. The book of Ephesians chapter 4. We'll start reading from verse 11. Ephesians chapter 4. We'll start reading from verse 11. Chichi, God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and some teachers. I will repeat one more time. Ephesians chapter 4 from verse 11. And he gave some. He gave. So when we are called, we are not just called to be here and be watching. We are not just called here as a non-entity. We are not just called here just to glance at the flow, just to glance or to look at the flow of things as it is going. We are not called without purpose. We are not called without being glorified. We are not called and abandoned empty. He said he gave. So there is a package that is being released to us. Anytime we submit ourselves as a child of God, or the day we determined, we made up our mind to worship him in the church, he gave some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, and some teachers. Why? Verse 12. For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. We are all called into ministry. Gbogbo wa pata la pe sise Oluwa. Ona ta fi gba pe wa ati ise ta pe wa si lo yato. We are all called into the ministry. But the difference is that we are called in different ways and for different purpose. We are called in different ways and different purpose. But the bone of contention, the most important thing that I need you to understand here is that you are called. You are called. Being a celestial is a calling. Being a celestial is a calling. And that is why, by divine injunction, the day you submit or agree to worship God in this holy fold, now you are mandated to take a spiritual cleansing. And before you partake in the spiritual cleansing, they sing the song, Jesus lompe ototomabo. Jesus is calling you, all sinners come. So that song that is being rendered to you first is an establishment of the fact that ye are called. We are all called into celestial to worship. Jesus lompe ototom. So we need to get that fact right first, that being a celestial is by calling. You see, there are some people out there, no matter how much you preach to them, no matter how much you brand Celestial Church of Christ to them, no matter how much you package your church or your parish, no matter how much you try to sweeten them, they will not join Celestia. This is not a cause. No matter how much you persuade them, spend billions of dollars on Christian programs, package your church, brand it, let your church always be on CNN 24/7. There are some people, no matter what, if I preach blood out of your mouth, they will not, that will not make them to become a Celestial. Why? Because they are not called into this fold. So never force people to join your church. No, you don't have to force people to join Celestial Church. No, you don't have to brainwash people. No, you don't have to persuade them. You don't have to drag people. Those that the Lord has called, those that the Lord has purposed in his heart to be used of him in this fold, will willingly come. They may be an antagonist to this grace now, just like Saul before he became Paul. They may not even want to hear anything about this fold now, just like Saul before he became Paul. They may be the head of persecutors of the church now. They may be the ringleader in always showcasing the negative side of the church. They may even not want to see you at all. They may even not want to do anything about you because you are Celestial. You don't need to feel bad about that. That does not make you a lesser Christian. Just leave them. Abandon them to their own thoughts. Why? Because if the Lord has called them to his holy purpose and righteousness in this fold, they shall willingly, at the right time, find their way to the fold of light. So don't be too fanatical. You cannot fight for God. If God has called some people to baptize, let everybody baptize. If God has called some people to be a Catholic, let everybody Catholic. If God has called some people to worship and redeem, there's nothing you can do. They will worship as a redeemer. But that does not make them a better Christian than I am because I worship in Celestial Church of Christ. Listen, we are all going to the same heavens. The same heavens that we are going to, there is no denomination. When we get to heavens, they will not ask you, who is your pastor? When we get to heavens, they will not ask you, where did you worship on earth? When we get to the heavens, when we get to heaven, they will not ask you, what is your church address? The only criteria, the only standard is how righteous and how obedient you have lived in your life. The only criteria is to be sure of your salvation in him. Is to be sure of your salvation in him. When your salvation is guaranteed and you live your life as a true son or daughter, then heaven is guaranteed. Heaven is guaranteed. So the assignment in the world is so wide, and the Lord decided to split the assignment into different departments. And he chose different heads of departments into each department to lead as the lead. Evangelist Femi Sola Okunola, God bless you, bro. God bless you. I see the good works that you are doing. Olorun Bubuwaleri, in the mighty name of Jesus. So the work here in this world is so enormous. It's not a poetry. The work of saving the whole world is a very massive one. So in order for this world to be impactful, in order for this work rather to be effective, what did God do? He decided to create departments. And what are the departments? Denominations. Those are the departments. Department of Celestia, Department of CNS, Department of Deeper Life, Department of this one, Department of that one. He decided to create departments. And then he decided, because when there is a department, there will be HODs. So he decided to put some heads of department. Who are the heads of the department? Your general overseer and our pastors. Those are the heads of department. And he put everybody, every one of us, he established us and chose us into our department to work in different capacity, but what? For his intention to be manifest till we all come in the unity of the faith. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 13, he called some as this one, he called some as that one, he called some as that one for the perfecting of the saints, for the perfecting and for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Now verse 13, till we all come in the unity of faith. So when we get to heaven, we are coming into unity. We are becoming one unified body. So you don't force anybody to worship in celestial. You don't drag nobody. You don't pick fight with them. And if anybody sees you as a nobody or as a non-entity because you worship in celestial church of Christ, just abandon them to their own purpose, because they are acting according to their wisdom. They are acting according to how much their understanding can carry them. Listen, if this church is not of God, it would have died before I was born. But because it is of God, that is why it is still existing. So where are we coming from? You have to understand the fact that being a celestial is a calling. You are called to worship here. And not just worshiping here alone. We are all called into ministry. Into ministry. Romans chapter 8, 29. Romans chapter 8. Verse 29, Romans chapter 8, verse 29. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate. Those he foreknow, he predestinate. Listen, there are some people, no matter how much you preach, they can't accept Christ. Take that, believe it or not. No matter how you preach Christ, no matter how you take the salvation of Christ to them, they will not receive it. They will not. Because they are not predestinate to enjoy in this salvation package. Now, for whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Verse 30. Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them also he called. Whom he predestinate. That is, you have been predestinated to worship here in this fold at this time of your life. Oti wale ninu anyomore ninu akole anyomore pe kerubu lo ma se sele lo ma se. It has been predestinated in your destiny that at this time of your life you will be in CNS, you will be in celestial church, you will be in redeemed, you will be in MFM, you will be in Baptist. It has been predestinated. Now for those he has predestinated, he called. So he predestinated it before you were born. Now when you were not born, he called you, number one, into his love by giving your life to him and being redeemed and being saved as a Christian. Then those whom he called, he justified, and whom he justified, he glorified. So after you have fully immersed yourself in the knowledge of this assignment, and after you have adequately run your race till the end, then we are all glorified in the mighty name of Jesus. He shall glorify us. So now, that was why I need us to understand the fact that we are all called into ministry, and anointing is one of the as a matter of fact, anointing is the backbone for a success in ministry. You need to understand first, like I said in my introduction, that we were all called. We are all called into the ministry. We are all called. We are in it together. Although he called us in different capacities and for different purposes and reasons, but the fact still remains, we are all called. Now, for you and I now to function effectively, for you and I to function effectively in the calling whereby we have been called, for you and I to function effectively in the calling whereby we have been called, then we need the anointing. We need the anointing. Because without the anointing, we may not be able to function adequately. Now, straight to the question. Why do I need this anointing? Why is it so important? Why do I need? Number one reason why we all need the anointing is to be like him. To be like who? To be like Jesus. So the first reason why we need the anointing, 1 John chapter 2, verse 6. Admin, please help me. I see that you are doing your work, but please God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. 1 John chapter 2, verse 6. He that said he abideth in him ought himself also walk, even as he walked. 1 John chapter 2, verse 6. 1 John chapter 2, verse 6. He that saith he abideth in him, but ought himself to walk on pelu latin, even as he walked. Gege bi Jesu tirin. So if you claim to be abiding in Christ, if you claim to have been saved, if you claim to be a true child of God, then we need to walk as Jesus has walked. Now, but we need to understand this fact that in sins and iniquity did our mothers conceived us. So in our Christian race, in running towards perfection, we have to be mindful of this important thing that is called the flesh. That is called what? The flesh. As we are striving towards salvation, as we are running our race towards perfection, we all must be very mindful of this thing that is called flesh. Am I speaking to somebody? What do I mean by flesh? That part of you that makes you to keep sinning even when you don't want to sin anymore. That part of you that makes you to keep backsliding, returning back to your old ways, even when you hate to do so. Now, we need the inner power. We need a superior power. We need the grace wherein Jesus has walked in order to help us to be like Jesus. So, what is this inner power that we all need? What is this grace that we all need? That is the anointing. That is the anointing. That is the anointing. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. 2 Corinthians chapter 3. I'm going to establish every fact from the scriptures. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 from verse 17. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 from verse 17. Now, the Lord is that spirit. And where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Verse 18. But we all with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord. We are beholding the glory of the Lord with open face, like or as if it's in a glass. Then we are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as the Spirit of the Lord. So it is the anointing that will help us to constantly focus our gaze on Christ. It is the anointing that will help us to fuel our energy and then to refueling us and then to re-energize us towards running our race so that we will not run out of the oil. So, number one reason, why do I need the anointing? The first reason why I need to be operating in the anointing is to be like him. So that I can be like the master. So that I can be like Jesus. Number two, I am moving very, very fast because we have a lot of things to cover today. Number two, why do I need the anointing? Why do I need the anointing? For the impouring of his spirit inside of me. For the impouring. Now we are getting deeper now. We are going deeper now, and I don't want you to miss it. Please, if you are just joining us and you are yet to share this live broadcast, please, I would like us to do that now. And I say, God bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Number two, why do I need the anointing? For the impouring of the Spirit to get inner strength. To get inner strength. Now, let me simplify it a little bit for us to understand by saying it this way. By saying it this way. Anointing is of three kinds. But for the purpose of this teaching, I will tell us the first two kinds. Or let me just limit it to two. Let's limit it to two now for the purpose of this teaching. Two types. Number one, we have the anointing that is within. And then number two, we have the anointing that is on us. I hope someone is getting me now. Number one, we have the anointing that is in us. Number two, we have the anointing that is on us. So, why do I need the anointing? To gain inner strength from the anointing that is within. To gain inner strength. To be able to function, to gain inner strength, to be able to stand the test of time, to gain inner strength, to be able to withhold the storm when it comes. Why? How do I gain inner strength? Because of the anointing that is within. Because of the anointing that is within. Because of the anointing that is within. Please, I want everyone who is watching me right now to get a clear understanding. Let us quickly go to 1 John chapter 2, verse 27. This is serious now. Don't joke with it. 1 John chapter 2, verse 27. But the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you. 1 John chapter 2, verse 27. But the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you. It abided. That is the anointing that is within. The anointing that you have received. This one is not the one that will come and that will go. I want to remind us of the operational power in Samson. When it was time for Samson to fight for the Israelites. When it was time for Samson to conquer the Philistine. The Bible says, the Spirit descend on him. The Spirit descend on him. And at this time, when the Spirit descends on him, he felt the move of power. And at that time, you dare not challenge Samson. Because at that period, he began to do what naturally he may not be able to do. Why? Because of the ascension of the anointing. Obali. Now, when that anointing descend on him, after completing the particular assignment for which the anointing descended on him, the anointing will return back. Now, that is the anointing without that descend on. But the first anointing that we are talking about never falls on you and return back. This is the one that remains in you permanently. It stays inside of you. The anointing that is within. Ye have received of him abideth in you, and you need not that any man teach you. When you receive this anointing, you need not that any man teach you, but as the same thing, the anointing teacheth you of all things. But as the same anointing teacheth you of all things, and is truth, and is no lie, and even as it hath taught you, ye shall abide in him. It is true. There is no lie in it. and ye shall abide or remaineth in it. The anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you, and you don't need any man to teach you. Why do I need the anointing? Why do I need the anointing? So that I may be taught adequately of the things of God. When you receive this anointing, it is this anointing that teaches you. None of us were a preacher when we became a Christian. And none of us was born like, go and be a preacher. None of us was born with the word. We got to the world and we sat down and begin to read and eat the word. And that is when we are now able to preach the word. Now, the anointing is that thing that distinguishes you. The anointing is that thing that sets you apart. Because you are not taught from the hand of any mortal man. You are not taught from the hand of any mortal teacher. What the anointing will teach you, you cannot get in any Bible college. What the anointing will teach you, you cannot get in any seminary. Why do I need the anointing? In order to be taught by the Spirit of God. He said, this anointing that abided in you will teach you. You don't need to start seeking for who will teach me this. How do I? It is the anointing that will be teaching you. Not only teaching you, it will guide you into 100% truth. So in other words, your preaching will be void of heresy. You won't be preaching out of context. You won't be preaching what the Bible did not say. You won't mount the pulpit and be preaching stories. Because you are connected with the source. You are connected with the power. And each time you open your mouth, the anointing begins to speak. And then the power begins to flow. Oh, is there anybody watching me now that is craving for the anointing? Is there anybody watching me now that is craving for the anointing? I want to pray for seven people. I want to pray for seven people. I want to pray for seven people for the release of the mighty rush of the anointing of God upon them and in their lives. For this anointing that abided in you shall teach you into all things that is true. That is true. How do you know what to preach? How do you even know what to pray about? It is the anointing. In other words, the anointing is a teacher and a guide. Sister Victoria Fajano, the first person, I decree in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember, I taught us about the transfer by radiation, by the purpose of your good intention, and by the reason of this ministration. I decree into your life, Victoria Fajana, Adetayo Adetola Adex, my brother and friend Isaac Badaru, Rotimi Ajayi, there shall be a mighty flow of the anointing and the power of God in your lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Ola Bisi Ola Dele Isaac Badaru. Rotimi Ajayi Adetayo Ades Victoria Fajana. As from this moment, you shall begin to operate in high volatile, high voltage of the power of the anointing in the mighty name of Jesus. Why do I need the anointing? To be directly taught of God. This anointing which you have received. Do not forget, I said there are two kinds. Number one is the anointing that is within. In your man, Bekakirin. Do not forget our aim. The first one says, Jesu ti joba. Baraye fe baraye ko. Jesu ti joba. And the second aim says, Jesu benu mi. Jesus abided in me. That is the second type of anointing. Nye ya to si e mi mo so ka le sanre wa. awamise ire tire, Holy Spirit descend into our midst. That is a kind of anointing. When the Holy Spirit descends, the whole place is shaking. Everybody feels the move of the power, and it descends on the prophets that are available, blah, 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 and performs his wonder. And then the prophet opened their mouth, and then it begins to speak to them. And after that, the spirits return back. It returns back. So, and that is why many times you see some prophets or prophetess. You see some prophets and prophetesses who still drink beer, who still fornicate, who still keep malice, who are still bleaching, who still even smoke. And at the same time, when the Spirit of God descends, they open their mouth and gives you raw prophecy. Raw prophecies, 100% true. Talk about what you buy, raw prophecy. And after that, the spirit that descended on them, because it cannot indwell that cavity of sin, it returns back. We are not talking about yet. We are talking about the spirit that abided in you. So why do I need the anointing? In order to be taught and to be guided. In order to be taught and to be guided. In order to be taught and to be guided. You said this particular anointing, when you receive it, you don't need nobody to begin to teach you. You don't need nobody to teach you. What this anointing will teach you, honestly, no Bible college will teach. What this anointing will teach you, honestly, no theology, no seminary will teach. Many times I just open my Bible to read just verse 1. Just by reading just one verse in the scriptures. By the time I look at my notes, I have written like 5 pages just by reading just one verse. How am I getting all these stuff that I am writing? Who is teaching me? Who is telling me? How did I know? All these stuff that I'm writing and preaching and speaking and saying. Stuff that my dad has not even yet taught me. How did I come across it? The anointing. The anointing. When you grab just one verse of the scriptures, the anointing, we can split it into 1,000,000 ways for you. The same John chapter 3 verse 16, for God so loved the world. You can preach it in 1,000,001 ways by the anointing, and it guides you. You will not preach heresy. You will not preach false teachings. You will not preach what you are not supposed to preach. Why? The anointing. So, why is this anointing so important? Because it abided in you. God, why do I need to have this anointing inside of me? Because it upholds you. That anointing teaches you, it guides you, and upholds. So, the anointing is like a pillar. It's a pillar that upholds your life. It's like a pillar. And it is that anointing that helps your spiritual growth. Now, every child of God, when you become a Christian, God gives us 3 gifts. When you become a child of God, when you become an anointed minister of God, you are given 3 gifts. Oh, I have received Christ. Oh, I don't want to look back at my horrible past. Immediately, because of your sincerity to follow him, you are given 3 packages or 3 gifts. Number 1 is hunger. The ability to be hungry for God. The ability to be hungry for God. The anointing will help you. You begin to hunger for the things of God. You begin to hunger. Even as a preacher, if you are not invited to a program to preach, you can face the wall and start preaching to the world. You just feel that hunger to do stuff for God. You feel that hunger to know God more. You feel that hunger to search God deeper. So the anointing, number 1, gives you a gift of hunger, to be hungry for God. The number 2, it gives you faith.
And the more you continue to abide this in this anointing, the greater your faith starts getting bigger, the bigger your faith becomes. It gives you faith. And that's why you have not even seen God, but you believe God exists. You have not even seen Jesus, but you believe he exists. So that is by faith. And then it makes your faith to keep growing. And then number three, it gives you love. Love of God. Love of everything around you. Love of the sinners. You don't want them to perish. You don't want nobody to suffer. So that is as a result of the anointing that is within. It teaches you. It guides you. And it upholds you. The anointing that is within is the pillar of the Christian life. If you lose or miss this anointing, then your Christian race has finished. Now, why do I need the anointing? Number three. Why do I need the anointing? Number three. For what? For empowerment. For empowerment. In other words, for the outpouring of the anointing. Acts of Apostles chapter 1 verse 8. Acts of Apostles chapter 1 verse 8. But ye shall receive power, after which the Holy Ghost is upon you. Upon you. And ye shall be my witnesses in this and that. Ye shall receive power, after which the Holy Ghost is upon you. The first anointing that abideth in you. The second anointing that is upon you. The first one goes directly and then begin to operate inside of you. But the second one comes upon you. Now, what are the examples, or what are the anointing, or what are the benefits of the anointing that comes upon? Of the anointing that comes upon you is the ability to prophesy, ability to see visions, ability to work at miracles, ability to speak in tongues, ability to interpret tongues, and all forms of spiritual gift, ability to hear the word of God, ability to be able to give the word of knowledge. These are as a function of the anointing that comes upon you. What? For what? For empowerment. Oh, Kumara. For what? For empowerment. To give you power. To empower you. To empower you. So, what kind of empowerment? To supply you with divine power, to be able to do supernatural things, to be able to look at someone, you look at a fellow, and then you begin to tell them what food they ate yesterday, what problem he or she has been passing through, and what he is going through today, and the solution of an assured future. That is by the anointing that comes upon you. Let me just leave it at that level for now. Later, at the conclusion of the topic of anointing, then we will go deeper. We will go deeper in it. So for empowerment, it empowers you, gives you different forms of gift. You begin to function. The first one abideth in you and illuminate the word of your mouth. It abideth in you, and then it illuminates the words of your mouth. Toban sorrow, anointing loma toy moles yoro. So everybody will clearly understand what you say as a teacher, as a preacher, as a pastor, as an evangelist. Everybody will understand, because you don't speak ordinary words, you utter illuminated words. Am I speaking to somebody now? When there is disorganization in a place, I'm speaking to the ministers in our midst now. when there is a spirit of lukewarmness, maybe you go to a program and the previous ministers that just ministered before you, but when you're concerned, everything that he was doing, his preaching, his ministration, everything, people were just sleeping. People were just tired. You hardly hear them say amen. You are forcing them to say amen. The atmosphere is just dull. It's like nothing is happening. And we claim to be in the presence of God. But as soon as they invite you and you come to the microphone and you just say, somebody shout hallelujah. You have not started preaching. You just utter, let somebody shout hallelujah. And people that were sleeping immediately jump to their feet. Why? Illumination. Why? Illuminated words just came out. Bam! You go straight into the heart and destroy all false, all works of darkness in their heart. Bam! It hits their heart and they bring them out of their lukewarmness, bring them out of their sleepiness. And then people begin to wonder, where did this one come from? Where did they bring this man? It is not that man. It is not that preacher. It is the anointing that is within. That is within. That is within. So if you have ever been dreaming to function in ministry, if you have ever dreamt to be a preacher, if you have ever dreamt to hold the microphone and minister to people, you need to begin to crave the anointing as from now. You need to begin to run after the anointing with your life. Because without the anointing, being in ministry can never be profitable. You will be like the others. It is the anointing that sets you apart. It is the anointing that sets you apart. It is the anointing that sets you apart. A lot of people, my God, a lot of people went to John the Baptist to be baptized the same day Jesus went. It was not Jesus only. It was not only Jesus that was baptized that day. A lot of people went for baptism. But as soon as it came to the turn of Jesus, as he stepped into the river to be baptized, as soon as they baptized him, dipped Jesus into the river, and Jesus came out. Immediately the Bible says the heavens opened and then there was a voice. It was not only Jesus that had the voice. Everyone that was there had the voice of confirmation. He said, this is my beloved son. Hear he him. Why was Jesus set apart? Because of the anointing. He was set apart. But he was set apart. Why? The anointing. Number two, the heavens was open. Listen. If heavens has not opened when you are ministering, you cannot minister effectively. The heavens was opened, and then God began to speak. He wasn't speaking to Jesus alone. Everybody lo bo. So to bafe minister ki gbogbo eyan de ma gbo won Olorun pe baba mi soro alagbada ina soro alawo tele orun soro wo fe ko ma soro ku ohun e dabi ohun Olorun. You need to run after the anointing. Run after, chase the anointing with everything that you have. Then he began to orun koko soro. That is confirmation. But this one that is just baptized is not like the others. Orun soro, confirmation. So it is the anointing that gives confirmation to everything that you do. Then number three, recommendation. What is the recommendation? Hear ye him. Ele itemi ni o, e ma gbo ti e. So you went for a program and you shout, you did all of this, and you did this one, you did that. Nobody even noticed that you are there as a minister. It is because you don't have the anointing. Because when you have the anointing, they will hear you. Hear ye him. E ma gbo ti re. What? Let them invite you. Go invite us. I want let them invite you to get to among area boys. Go invite us. Your bashewo or bawiri. Because just somebody shout hallelujah. Everybody will sit down to listen. It is not your power. It is the anointing that will compel them to listen. Anointing. Anointing. I can't deal with it anymore. Eje ka gbadua adua ta fe bare emi mimo lato ni lo so mi deni tayin gbotie ayayayayayaya eje ka gbadua I can feel a mighty rush of the power now emi mimo. Don't worry, I will interpret in English for those of you that may not understand that prayer, but I will interpret. But it will sopi emi mimo emi mimo emi mimo lato ni lo. So me deni ta yen gbotie on ta ye afi bo mi ta afi gbon mi ta fe ri mi oluwa je ko be se fa no aye mi. Somebody begin to pray. Oh God my Father, oh God my Father, oh God my Father, as from this moment make me the man, make me someone that the world will listen to in the mighty name of Jesus. Make me Lord, the move of your power, the move of the Spirit that will make people to sit attentively, to hear what I've got to say, and then to win them over to you. Let it begin to operate in my life. All who are summoned in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have ever seen any minister that performs so brilliantly well with the flow of power, I do at nobody. Oluwa, one fair one call, one ba one ba. She me learn it. I fair ball in the mighty name of Jesus. The anointing that will make the whole world to want to listen to what I have to say and to respect what I carry, and then to win them over to your kingdom. Let it begin to function. Let it begin to function. Let it begin to function in my life. I crave the anointing that people will listen. So me then tie in both here. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Am I speaking to somebody now? So it was the anointing that sets Jesus apart. At the bab, my God. This one was not in my notes. That's what I'm telling you now. That's what I was telling you. At the baptism of Jesus, three things happened by the reason of the anointing. If Jesus was not anointed, do not forget, I told us last week, God, whom he has anointed Jesus as he went about doing good. So the book of Acts of Apostles established that Jesus was anointed. Now, at the baptism of Jesus, the anointing gave us the proof. Three things happened. Number one, there was separation. And you ministers, change bombing clearly. At the baptism of Jesus, by the reason of the anointing, three things happened. Number one, there was separation. Jesus stepped out of the crowd among the multitude that was baptized. His own was different because he was the only one that the dove descended on. The dove did not descend on all other Christians. Do not forget that before you submit yourself for baptism, you must have received the good news. You must have become a Christian. You must have been born again before you submit. You must have accepted the gospel before you submit for baptism. So all of them that were actually baptized were not sinners. Kin se ni joti wan si to pe awon asewo la nko lo sere bomi fun ta ba tun sere bomi fun ton wa to pada si di asewo won. We are not talking about that one. They were not sinners. They have abandoned their sins and then decided to go with Jesus. So all of them were saved and sanctified. But among them, among the pastors, among other ministers, among other prophets, Jesus was set aside. The Holy Spirit descended like dove. There was separation. Among the prophets, you must be set aside. You must be special. Among preachers, you must be special. Among ministers, you must be special. There must be one unique thing about you, and you cannot achieve that if not by the anointing. So at the baptism, there was separation. He was separated. Number two, there was what? Confirmation. This is my beloved son. They had God. So for some of them that are still doubting, is he Christ or is he not Christ? Is he the chosen one or not the chosen one? He didn't want to be sent or not the one to be sent. There was a confirmation. This one is my beloved son. So when you carry the anointing and you begin to minister, and then maybe some demonic forces are around the corner and they want to operate, they will hear the voice. You will be woman, she shall not tell, just be preaching. You'll be preaching on your own ministry, but those forces will hear the voice that this is my beloved son. And then the spirit of God will minister to them that it has been written that touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. Touch not who? My anointed. If he's not anointed, he can be touched. If he's not anointed, he can be disciplined. If he's not anointed, he can be tied down. If he's not anointed, he can be afflicted. If he's not anointed, he can be fought. If he's not anointed, he can be destroyed. But if he's anointed, he carries an emblem of a touch not. Touch not. Am I speaking to somebody now? So there was a confirmation. There was a confirmation. And then number three, there was recommendation. Hear ye him. Emma Botire, recommendation. Heavens will attest to the fact that when you carry the anointing, to jade la share on one my jerry arepe awalaran egbotie. On one my jerry ni. Heavens will attest to the fact that this one belongs to us. Hear ye him. So that is what recommendation. So that those are the reasons why we need the anointing. Meta enough so that we can cover others. Let me limit it to that three for now, so that we can cover the other things to be covered. Now let's go to the second stage of the teaching today. Has this ministration blessed you this afternoon? Are you being blessed? Are you blessed? Are you feeling the impartation and the impartation? Because those are what the anointing will do. Whatever you, if you are not a preacher, if you are a singer, and you have the anointing of God in your life as a music minister, your song ministration will be full of impartation and impactation. When you sing, Idema Besin, Ja, bondages will be loosed. People will be set free. There will be deliverance. There will be rescue from the dungeon of the devil just by you singing. And this David, anytime he is invited to the palace, as soon as he begins to play his music on his harp, cunningly, the madness on the head of the king will fly away. We fly away. Why? An anointed hands was playing the instrument. So being anointed is not limited to preachers alone. As a keyboardist, you need anointing. As a guitarist, you need anointing. As a saxophonist, you need the anointing. As a talking drummer, you need the anointing. As an evangelist, you need the anointing. As a drama minister, you need the anointing. As a song minister, you need the anointing. Why? Because it is the anointing that will not make you to be ordinary. When you lack the anointing, you are as ordinary as that word, ordinary. Nothing special about you. But when you carry the anointing of God upon your head, everything that you do becomes so special. Because God will indwell what you are doing, and he will attest and recommend you and separate you, set you apart. So you need the anointing. You need the anointing. So one other thing that the anointing does for you is that apart from that, you know, remember I told you your words, the words of your mouth. The anointing does two things to the words of your mouth. I told you one. I am here to tell you the second. These ones are not in my notes. I'm just speaking according to the flow. The anointing does two things to your word. To Odusonya or Kewo or Molola Kubrat and Rotimi Ajayi. God bless you. I'm happy you are flowing. Are being precious. God bless you. I'm glad you are flowing. The anointing does two things to the words of your mouth. Number one, I said it illuminates your world. The same Genesis 1:1 that somebody preached and it was meaningless to people. That same Genesis 1:1, even before you begin to preach at your introduction, people will begin to get delivered. Illuminated world. At point, see, oro, enue. Then the second thing that the anointing does to the words of your mouth is that it amplifies. It amplifies. You know, when you have amplifier, what is an example of an amplifier? A speaker, a loudspeaker. I can speak now in my bedroom and you can hardly hear me. But let me speak into a microphone that is connected to a speaker, to a loudspeaker. What happens? Then my voice becomes amplified. Before I was speaking, I could hardly hear what I'm saying. The only people that could hear what I was saying are the people in my bedroom. I want to know yara mini kandale bounty moon so. Now, when the anointing comes in, your words become amplified. An example of an amplified word is when you were talking lowly before and then you are handed over a microphone that was connected to a very loud speaker. What happens to your voice? It becomes amplified, and then the people in the neighborhood begins to hear that somebody is talking. Idito se soro tan se boy. Idito se je pe street yin ni kan lati mo e. Oni pe o ti bere ifami ororun yan. You have not asked for the anointing of God. When you don't have the anointing of God upon your head as a minister, you are as good as a local champion. You won ba bule yin ni kan wanti ma gbo e. Local parish yin ni kan wanti ma gbo e. Youth night te kan se ni uni church yin ni kan wanti ma gbo e. Ibe ni kan ni. Your glory and fame will not span outside. It will not break forth and break free outside your comfort zone because your voice is not yet amplified. Now, when you catch a glimpse of the anointing and the anointing becomes to manifest in your life, before you see anything, they catch it in Japan, they catch it in Canada, they catch it in America, it is amplified. What you are saying begins to have meaning. You begin to say meaningful things that is setting people free. So the anointing amplifies your word. The anointing amplifies. Now I don't want to waste this grace. Let me write it down. Let me write it down. Anointing does what? Number one, what did I say? Illuminates. Number two, amplifies. And number three, glorifies. It glorifies. You remember I said two before. You remember I told you this. What I'm saying is they are not in my notes. I'm just speaking according to the flow of the unction of the Spirit of God. So when you carry the anointing of God, it does three things to your word. If you have ever dreamt to prosper in anything that you do, this is not limited to spiritual world alone. It is limited even to secular world. At your office, you want to speak and you want your boss to listen. You want everyone in your office to always listen to what you have to say, because it is only when you speak that solution will come. That can only be achieved by the anointing. Even though the main reason why we are given the anointing is for spiritual exploit. And everyone needs spiritual exploit because everyone is called into ministry. Even though he called some to be a pastor, he may not call you as a pastor, but he calls you as a prophet or as a teacher, as an evangelist, as an apostle. He called us in different capacity, and we cannot function effectively if we are not anointed. And how does people know that you are anointed? Number one, they get to know that you are anointed when you are just speaking. Just like the first thing we get to know about God is by his word. The first thing that we get to know about God that made us to believe God is his word, or was his word. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. We just know that somebody created, and darkness was everywhere, and we know, and everywhere was in disarray and formless and void, and we know. And then the Spirit of God was moving upon the river, and we know. After that, God said, let there be light. And there was light. And everything that you are seeing that is good today came about by the spoken word of God. So ishi agbara koko ti Olorun koko se ohun ni lati lo agbara oro. I am releasing word into your life now. Mo lo agbara oro sori aye re bayi. Ohun gbogbo ti o ni tumo laye re tele by the reason of the word that is coming out now. Ko babara itumo. In the name of Jesus. Those of you that are calling me now, I don't appreciate it. You can see that I'm ministering life. Don't call now. Wait till after I finished ministering. Wait till after I ended this live broadcast. Then you can call me. Don't call me now. I can't pick your call up. It's obvious. So by his word. So when people hear your word, three things must happen. When they listen to your word, number one, your word is illuminated. Ama mu imole si gbogbo bi to ba daru. Wa gbo ah, oro yo ne niyanju o afeti professional ba de o. Oro yo le niyanju o afeti prophetess bimbo ba de. They will be telling themselves, this matter cannot be sorted until Prophet Kunle comes, because they know that no matter how ruju po, how disarray, how confident and this anything that the matter on ground is, the moment Prophet Kunle comes in and say, let's do this, there will be solution. Why? Because it speaks illuminated word. Number two, your word is amplified. You are heard in all the world. And number three, the last one as I go to the next segment, is that your word is glorified. Your word is glorified. And there will be salt. You begin to speak salted word. Or we have been doing, or we are ta, let your eye, and 19, no more in your ta. Other Pierre, what in Nagbobo, what Pierce National Stadium, you will not ferry, you will not fair go, or the big microphone, yeah, and it started to the end of 5 million. See Crusade, main minister, or they say, hallelujah, but when you're the best in soon, check yourself. They have spent like 5 million, $10 million to organize a very great outdoor crusade, and you are the main minister, and then you got there, just somebody shout hallelujah from start to finish, people were sleeping. Why? Because your word has not been salted. Until your word is not glorified. When your word is glorified, people will listen with keen interest, and not just listen with keen interest, there will be manifestation and the flow of power in the words that comes out of your mouth. Or we have been seeing Shishi Agbara. Yato sipe abuyosi. Awa besi shekini. Abe sin Shishi Agbara. Manifestation of power. Let me cite an example about this issue of manifestation of power. I was invited by a shepherd in our region on Monday. I was invited by a shepherd on Monday for a christening ceremony. There was a naming ceremony of a baby in that church, and that was the first of its kind. And the shepherd said, this is the first time we are having naming ceremony in our church. I don't want just anybody to come in as prophet to carry the baby boy that was just given birth to, because it's a celestial church of Christ. You bring your child to the church on naming ceremony. If the child is a boy, a prophet carries the boy, names the boy, and unleash spiritual message about the future of that boy. And if the child is a girl, a prophetess is invited to carry the girl and then give the girl a name and then reveal spiritual messages and directions about the life of that girl. So I was opportune and privileged to be invited to carry that boy. And something happened. As soon as I got to the premises, I noticed that some four or five people were talking about me. And I, you know, when you're talking about me, I know. I just pretend if I don't want to answer. So as I was getting out of my car, I noticed that some five people were talking about me. And as I was approaching them, I heard them mentioning VOA, you know, our Monday program. And I went close. I said, I think you were talking about our program. Do you watch our program? I wanted to thank them for watching our program, and then to encourage them not only to watch our program, but to share and broadcast it, send it to people. So that was my intention. As I got there, I said, I heard you are talking about our program, Abi. They said, yes. I said, thank you for what the woman said. No, that was not even the reason. He said, last week Monday, I was in my house. And someone shared, you know, if we tell you on our program that share, send it to people, you don't know what you are doing to people. This woman was pregnant, heavily pregnant, and due to be given back. She was due, Oyekoti Bimo. And she was at home watching, she was at home, and somebody shared the link to our live broadcast, VOA, two Mondays ago, somebody shared the link. And then she said she clicked on the link, and then I was on her screen, and she was watching. And then the period whereby she was watching was when I told people to get a bottle of water, and I was praying on water. And she said, Adua Lungba, Abarako, it is prayer that is needed. And she went to grab her own bottle of water, and she was responding, amen, 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 till we finished the program. And she said, after the live broadcast, this was what happened Monday. After the live broadcast, she said she drank the water. And immediately after, few minutes after drinking the water, she started feeling somehow. And she was taken to the hospital, and she gave birth easily. And she was glad. So once she had one program, because some program are actually inspired. Some program are actually good, that if you maintain your faith, stuff will happen. And we have never met. And then she brought the child to church for christening. And lo and behold, she saw me. So she thought someone actually invited me to eat rice and chicken at the naming ceremony. And I said, no. Fortunately, God is at work. I am invited to carry your child for naming. She was just perplexed. She couldn't say anything. She was speechless. I left her standing speechless, and I ran into the church to carry the baby. Now, we were having a program. The word was salted, was empowered, and glorified, and someone believed it. Someone who has been due, drank the water, few minutes later, started feeling labor, went to the hospital, got delivered easily. And as God will have it, that same prophet that ministered to her, she has never seen the prophet. The prophet has never seen her before. A shepherd from nowhere invited this prophet from nowhere to carry this same baby that was birthed out of VOA water. Isn't God wonderful? I was looking at the baby like that. I said, I'm a VOA. That is our God. I'm speaking to somebody now. So your word is what? Is glorified. When you speak, things will happen. Miracle will happen because God will attest to it. Now, let us go to the next phase. I have wasted too much time on that too. Okay. So, let us go to the next phase, which is how to receive the anointing. How to receive the anointing. How to receive the anointing. The first way. Amen. Mommy Fashola, God bless you, ma'am. How to receive the anointing. How to receive the anointing. Number one. Be mindful of your calling. Be mindful of your calling. Mojuto ipie. Be mindful. How to receive the anointing. Number one, be mindful of your calling. What do I mean by that? Carry a mentality that I am not just here, I am called. Carry a mentality that you are called. Mojuto ipie. Believe in your calling. Even if you are a side man or winner or usher, some people call them usher. Ko je oni bode lo je mi fe fi lasan because ko so ni bode lasan. Ko je oni bode first anointment as a side man or winner as a usher. Look, maybe it is first anointment that you carry. Have that strong faith and believe inside of you that you are called as an usher, and then function in the church as a called usher. So the anointing will not visit you if you are not operating in your calling. Because if you are not operating in your calling, when the anointing comes, in what capacity will it be useful for you? And I want you to believe and know something. That the anointing is like a two-edged sword. two-edged sword. What do I mean by that? It can bless and it can destroy. It blesses and it destroys. So I can't be coming here and telling the sweet things about the anointing alone. We are still coming back to that. The anointing blesses and it destroys. So when you claim for the anointing, and by the time the anointing comes, it doesn't meet you in your functionality, in your office, in your capacity, in your calling, then there is nothing the anointing will operate on. So, in order to get the anointing, number one, be mindful of your calling. Gbagbo ma mojuto ipere mojuto. Be mindful of your calling. Have a strong faith and believe that you are called. Gbagbo pa pe ni. Do not allow anybody to rubbish you or to bring you down. Do not allow anybody to lessen you, to look at you as a lesser vessel. No, there is no lesser vessel. Every vessel in the house of God is important and useful for one use or the other. I'm not speaking to somebody now. So, number one, you need to carry a mentality that this particular thing that I am doing in the house of God, I am called to do it. And when you are called to do something, you carry that mentality that one day or every time, I must return back to the one that called me to give a report, of how good, how well, or how wonderful I am doing in that calling. So, how do you get anointing? The first step is to believe that you are called. If you are a prophet, believe that you carry a calling. It is not only shepherds that are called. Believe that you are called as a prophet. And do not try to imitate anybody or try to be like anybody. Stay in your calling and then prosper in your calling. If you are a choir, have a strong faith that you are called in that church and in the house of God generally as a choir. When you go to church, when you go to Sunday service or any form of service as a choir, having or carrying a mentality in your head that you are called, you will not be in that choir stand and then when it is time for sermon and then you will walk away. Because that is what is happening in our parishes today. Choirs do not listen to sermon anymore. And that is why we don't have spiritual songs anymore. We don't have sensible songs anymore. That is why when they sing, people are not getting delivered anymore. Because the time of sermon, when you are supposed to receive fresh songs, fresh lyrics, fresh composition, the moment they start, the moment you finish singing only wasu like this, and the sermon begins by saying hallelujah, you take the back door, the side exit, and you leave the choir stand. No wonder as a choir, you have been ordinary. No wonder you are not like the dumb one of today. You are not like the Barbara of today. You are not like the Bolare of today. Why? There is no glory in your gift. Oh, ebun, la solo loko so gombe. Ebun, as a choir. If you lack the anointing, if you are not anointed as in your calling as a choir, you will only be using your gift. There is no glory in it. A lot of people have the same gift that you have. Go to garage. Loso gbele gba, losu opalende wa ra won yo to kon kon lasan, to ta won yo den fun won lowo. So you are not different from those people. It is the anointing that separates you and glorifies you. So even if you are a choir, you maintain your office as a choir, carrying the mentality that I am called. So anytime you are in the choir stand, Yarama, you sing with all seriousness, spirituality, and simplicity, knowing fully well that this is my own calling, this is what I'm called to do in this service, and I have to do it right. When it is time for someone, let him do his own. Service conductor is doing his own, let him do it. But prophets too, they are doing their own times, collect them. But as for me as a choir, I am called to this one. So you will sing with all your might and your power, and then the power of God will begin to flow. So be mindful of your calling. Be mindful of your calling. Of your calling. That is number one thing that you need to do in order to receive the anointing. Number two, I want to rush so I can finish this. I have like 20 minutes more. Number two, How do you receive the anointing? How do you receive the anointing? You must learn to pray deep, serious prayers. Deep prayers. Deep, deep, deep prayers. Deep prayers. There are prayers and there are prayers. You want the anointing, not this Jekure the prayer that you are praying. Father, in the name of Jesus, anointing. No. That's not the kind of prayer that we are talking about. Some of you, I said it the last time, if you want to sleep, and sleep is not coming, just tell them, Mother Celestia Jekoku, let's pray. As soon as she begins to pray 2 minutes, she will start snoring. Some people, prayer is their own sleeping pill. What it gets in him. Oh my God. You see some people, when they want to sleep and sleep is not coming, just tell them, let's pray. Before you begin to pray 2-3 minutes, you will hear them snoring already because prayer is their own sleeping pill. That is not the kind of people that we are talking about. That's not the kind of people we are talking about. You crave for the anointing, then begin to pray deep, targeted prayers. Deep, targeted prayers. Your prayers will be deep. And then you target your prayers. Let it be focused. You are not a prayer that is wavering. Not prayers that is wavering. You go directly to what you want. I've told my friend, Prophet Isaac Badara, I'm not sure if he's watching now. There was a time I told him that I make sure that every year I have one prayer point. I can have other prayer points too, but there is always one major prayer point every year. That is for me. To you, it may be wrong. I may have other things that I want, but there is always one major. And from January to December, till I get a testimony concerning that thing, I don't stop. One major one. So that is what you call a targeted prayer. What do we mean by praying targeted prayer? A focused prayer. You decide to pray within this period and that period, not requesting for anything other than the anointing. Lord, I crave for your anointing. Lord, I ask for your anointing. Lord, let there be a release of your anointing over my life. Lord, by your mercy, let there be a release. And you started praying from 9 p.m. You are still there at 12 midnight. You are still there at 2 a.m. And the only thing you are asking, Lord, it is time. Let your anointing fall. Let your anointing fall. And not just saying let your anointing fall. That is leading us to deep prayers. Then you begin to go into the details of what we have discussed today. Lord, because if your anointing falls on me, my world will no longer be ordinary. Lord, let your anointing fall on me. Because as from now, I want to be speaking illuminated word. By hitting those points, God will sit right. I think this boy knows what he's asking. Lord, I crave for your anointing. Like you poured the oil on David. Because as from now, oh Lord, I don't want the word of my mouth to be ordinary. I want to be speaking amplified word. I want to speak here and it will be heard all over the world. Lord, you're anointed. Let it flow because I need glorified word. You begin to go into details, mentioning, citing case studies before God. Because when you are praying, the Holy Spirit is your advocate, your lawyer. You are the one that is pleading your own cause. And God is the judge. And in every court of law, what will determine if you will win any case or lose any case is to make the judge hear what the law said about that particular case. Take the judge into the law of the land, that my Lord, the law of our land, Section 5, subsection 3, 4, clause 3, appendix 2. It says that is how to win a case at the court of law. You must be able to quote the law of the land. And then when you begin to quote the law of the land, that is what will buttress your point. And then the judge will say, oh, he's actually not guilty. And then they will set you free. Somebody is watching me and they will set you free. That is the same way it is in the spiritual. You need to load your prayers with the law. What is the law? Joshua, sir, you are going to prosper. Yes, sir. Now, for you to prosper, the law, this book of the law must not or shall not depart from your mouth, and ye shall meditate therein day and night. Now, what is the book of the law? It is the Bible. The only prayers that moves God, that springs God into immediate action, is that prayer that is loaded with the word. That is loaded with the word. That is loaded with the word. Take the word of God out of your prayers. Then what you are saying is no longer prayer. It is super story. You claim you are praying. There's no quotation of one word of God in your prayer. You know what the angels will be singing? This is super story. Learn no more than celestial. This is super story. That is what the angels will be singing to you. Because such prayers don't move God. So you load your prayers with what the word of God said. And let your prayers be moved with a very strong faith that I know that you will do it. That faith. So those are the things that will move you towards results. Are you getting it now? So load your prayers with what? The word of God. Oro Olorun lo mu ki adua gba kin se oro Yoruba. I have heard so many times. Some elders, some so-called elders in quotes, because I don't see them as elders anymore. Elders in quotes. Oluwa, iwe Yoruba lo so wi pe ori ediye o le yin buruko eh. Iwe Yoruba lo so wi pe ori ediye o le buruko ye yin dudu. Awon eniyan re sure fun iwo na den shame, and you are saying amen to such prayer. You are my father Ajagun of Chicago. God bless you, sir. God bless you. God bless you. You begin to prosper. You prosper more. You will prosper you more and more in the mighty name of Jesus. So you want to pray. Oh, our fathers are praying. Oh, Luwa, Ori Edie, Oli Bruko, Yedu Talon Sofun Ebe. Tedi Eba Joko, Sorry, Biton Ko Edusi. Tedi Eba My Jade, Ayipo Mo Edu. Ade Dudu. So that's not the kind of prayer that we are talking about. That is not the prayer. Afefe ki fe koma kongyoko lara. Tigi uba wa ni bita fefe udin koto wa ni bikona. That's not the kind of prayer. Prayers like incantation. Udu me tatag mani ko fika kanina talo sofe po juni. Talo sofe po juni. We are not talking about such. We are talking about spirit-filled prayers. We are talking about illuminated prayers. So, for you to get anointing, begin to pray the right and then deep prayers. Deep prayers. Deep prayers. Then number three, time is fast spent. I think I'm going to postpone number three and number four till next week. We've had enough. I don't want to overload us. Yes. But by the grace of God, I've been able to teach us about why do we need the anointing. Why do you need the anointing? I think we talked about 4 points. Why we need the anointing. And then we just finished the second point on how to receive the anointing. Number one way to receive the anointing is by being mindful of your calling and operating in the truthfulness of your calling. And then number two, begin to pray deep, direct, targeted, on point, and focused prayers. Begin to pray in that direction. Begin to pray. You want to be anointed. You want the anointing. You want to carry the same anointing like Elijah and Elisha. You want to carry the same anointing like Ezbe Joshua, Ayo Babalola, and Mose Urimolade. You want to carry that same anointing. Then begin to pray. Ask. He said, ask, and it shall be given. Now, you need to be mindful of your kind of prayers. You must pray the right prayers to get the right thing. Your kind of prayer must be a prayer that will move God. What are the prayers that moves God? Two things. Number one, prayers that is loaded with the truthfulness in His word. And then number two, prayer that is solidified with strong faith. That is solidified with strong faith. Not incantatory, if there's any English like that. not prayers of incantations. That is what the house of God has been turned into now. We have some elders, they hold the microphone in the church, claim to be praying for the church, but they are actually reciting incantation. They will pray from beginning to the end, from Jehovah to Jesu Oluwawa. You will not hear one thing about what the Lord has done, even maybe for Abraham or Sarah. You will not hear one thing about the word of God. You will not hear one thing, one quotation. Those are not kind of prayers that brings the anointing. So I encourage you to begin to pray the right prayers. Focus your prayer on what you want alone, and then let it be deep. And then with fasting, Jesus told the disciples, he said, all of this cannot be achieved if not by fasting. So if you want the anointing, not only prayer, learn how to fast, as a real fast. Not the kind of fasting that you fast and then you break your fast at 9 a.m. or 12. No, real fast. Dry fasting, white fasting, also all forms of fasting. Try it, you know, put it in your daily life. By that, your spiritual life will be lifted, and then you begin to experience the flow of anointing. I told us the last time that I'm going to entertain questions today. So is there one or two people that have one or two questions to ask as we close the program? I want to bring the program to a close now, but I want to quickly attend to one or two questions. So is there anybody in the house with one or two questions, maybe from our teaching last week or our teaching today? But let all your questions be focused on the topic, anointing. Anything outside anointing, any question outside anointing, I won't answer it. So let your questions be on what we have been discussing. So don't distract us. Yes. Ola Bisi, Ola Dele, any question? Prophetess for you, any questions? Faith Jibuno, any questions? Anaba Moses, Shade Fashola, Remi Oku, Kikela Momi, Dere Grace, Arowo Shegbe, Adebanki, Abolani, Wa. Yes. Any question before I pray for you and then I close up the program. We have just 2 minutes to do that as we bring the program to a close. Yes. So if there is no question, I will just pray for you and then release you under His grace and then just close the program. Yes. Any question? So since there is no question, I want to believe every topic discussed is well understood and grabbed and appreciated. Please do not just listen to the word alone, but put it into practice. Let's pray. Baba Alonwa Bioga, eternal rock of ages, we glorify your name for this grace. We thank you. And we pray that as we go, let the grace of the Lord go with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to operate in the fullness of your grace, because we know that when we operate in the fullness of your grace, we will never be disgraced. I decree in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for all your children that as you proceed in this week, everything you do shall prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus, everything you do shall prosper. You will not fail in anything. In the mighty name of Jesus, His grace shall abide with you. His peace shall abide with you. In the mighty name of Jesus, when doors are closed and shut against others, your doors shall be opened. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will prosper. You will do good. You will do well. Just like I shared someone's testimony today, the next time I will come, either on VOA or Celestial World, I will share your testimony. The whole world will hear your testimony. It shall be well with you. Begin to prosper. Go and do well. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please, on Monday, I'm going to lead a move towards getting support for this program. We want to create a separate department for partners on this program. So I'm going to be leading the move for that on VOA on Monday. If you are willing to partner with us in order to grow wider and grow bigger and therefore wider coverage, please do not hesitate to contact me. We are now reaching out and calling out for partners. The work is getting bigger and broader. And we want good children of God to partner with us so that we can grow bigger and then grow wider. How do you partner with us? I will go into the details on Monday. Pray in the mighty name of Jesus that as you do this, my God will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. So on Monday, those of you that belongs to VOA Prayer Connections on WhatsApp, I will send the details on our WhatsApp group even before Monday so that you have a clear understanding of what we are talking about. But I will speak about it for the first time online, live, on Monday. So I'm only preparing your mind. If the Lord has put anything in your mind to be of blessings to us so that we can grow wider and better, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that the Lord will bless you as you do so. In the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you. Thanks for watching. Till I come your way again next week, keep winning. Bye-bye.